baby beard.
Waited for you, Fry.
This episode traumatized me as a young person.
My head is hurting again.
Where's my firstborn son?
God does not care about me masturbating.
Your singing is bad and you should feel bad.
First get out into bus, so you're like, oh no!
Yeah. I don't like myself becoming the protagonist of this podcast.
You've been in
because you haven't learned anything.
Shut up and take my podcast.
Oh. I'll edit that so it goes for 10
Astounding.
Seconds longer.
Astounding. Amazing.
Make it seem as if I can hold a note.
Yes. Like you hold this show together.
Oh, MVP over here. As in the most valuable Paul.
Phil. Oh. Well.
I do get called Paul occasionally.
Yes. Yeah. Welcome, everybody.
Oh, God. Welcome, everybody, to Shut Up and Tape podcast, the Futurama podcast that spits episode against episode in bloody glorious gauntlet battle
for your entertainment.
Oh, and this is a side mission where we deviate from our regularly scheduled programming to bring you something a little different because you deserve it.
Can you tell that we've been on a break?
It has been almost a month since we last recorded.
And we've forgotten how to talk, essentially.
It's forgotten how to breathe.
It's winter and I've had a cough for the last 4 weeks.
I love that you said that I held the podcast together and then I had to do the intro because you were dying.
However, I must say, it's the Australian Futurama podcast.
Oh, no.
Now we're going to get confused.
Well, I'm British, so.
Yeah. You did try to take us over. I don't know. Did you? You took most of
Europe. You pretty much took over Australia.
Yeah, you. All the fills of the world.
Also, no one look at what's going on in the UK right now at all. Just
don't look at Australia.
Way.
Just don't look at any place and you'll be happy.
Keep your head down.
And listen to Shut Up and Take My Podcast.
Yeah, how about some pop culture escapism? Yeah.
Sounds good.
So, guys, what we're doing here today is still a side mission. I'm like, there is a reason. There's a method to the madness, and I'm not going to tell you, the audience, why we're not onto season 7 yet.
Do you want to tell her? Oh, we know. Yeah.
Yeah, we know. We know. Now we know. Is that a deep pull? Do you understand that? Now we know.
Knowing is half the battle.
No, peep show? Nah, forget it. Oh, well. So what we're doing this week on the Futurama podcast, as it were, is we're looking at the music of Futurama. And by looking, I mean listening.
As in looking about with our ears. Mm.
Because there's a lot. There's actually a lot of music in Futurama, and I've just been intrigued.
A lot of really good tunes as well.
And some of it's really bad and really badly mixed.
I do remember specifically a few episodes where I'm like,
I can't understand what they're singing.
Maybe these lyrics are funny, but I'd have no idea of knowing. So
which one was that? That was
it was the Kwanzaa one.
It was the Kwanzaa one.
It's
Toy Shop's Going to War.
It was
war.
Like a holiday
Yeah, it's a holiday-themed one, yeah.
Yeah, let's get...
Some of them are really good, like... The Devil's one is very good. And
anytime I go to say the
Welcome
Devil's...
Welcome to Robot Hell, which is found in Hell is Other Robots. Why?
And Hermes song from Hermes, how Hermes requisitioned his groove back.
Yeah.
Even if it's not a good idea.
Yeah.
I'm so glad I put the names of them up here.
That
so
one's
we can...
my favorite.
Yeah.
There's only one that we've actually never listened to yet because it hasn't come up.
It's later.
The Ballad of Mr. Ramblin' Rodriguez.
Oh, interesting.
Okay.
So
let's refresh our ear holes.
Oh, which one? Where do you want to go first? Where do you want to travel to?
I want to start with a good one.
Oh.
I want the Hermes one.
That's what I was thinking. We need to start
even if it's not a good idea?
Even if it's not a good idea, we should do it.
Let's do it. Let's find it. This is where I have to try and find it now. And I'm just going to, just keep vamping until I've...
music.
Yeah, really, there we go. Oh, it's under the bureaucrat song, which
That's
is wrong.
Good. Yeah.
Yes.
But when push comes to shove, you got to do what you love, even if it's not a good idea.
I just remember I fucking love that song.
It's like
the whole episode.
That's such a good one.
You've got the Caribbean feel. You've got, there's a key change in there that really ramps it up. Mm. It's just,
it's witty.
Lyrics are awesome. And the rhymes are just, the ones that you know are going to kind of come. And when they land, you're just like, yes, I was looking for that rhyme.
Like there's no, it's all of them singing. You can hear.
Yeah, yeah. And you get little bits of character stuff from each of them.
Except Fry. I don't think Fry sings at all in this, does he?
Yeah.
No. Jamaica!
They poo-pooed my electric Frankfurter.
And that's the best, I think, what was the episode about again? It was Bender just... That's right. She removed his personality?
Yeah. No, she... because she and Fry were hooking up. What was the reason?
Yeah.
She took his memory, basically, and sent it away so that...
But why?
I don't
And then
know.
Hermes has to go back to the central bureaucracy to find it, right?
You know, we literally watched this episode about 2 years ago.
She replaced him as a bureaucrat because of something... Was there something wrong with one of his...
Oh, they got a new bureaucrat,
yeah.
Was it his forms?
Number 19.
Was something wrong?
Or was it just to get back at Fry because he... Oh, God.
I don't know.
It was a great song, though.
Yes, and it's an awesome song. And it's a good episode as well. It's such fun.
Hermes is a great character, so...
That's part of like the reason episode. That I think that survived the majority of the season as our favorite episode before whatever ended up winning, which I'm
Roswell
Mother's Day.
Mother's Day. Mother's Day is so cool. I love
but
that
like
so much.
Also the juxtaposition of this song is fantastic because you've got this cool up tempo. Yeah. It's fun. The rhymes are very silly, and yet it's an ode to how much Hermes loves being a stickler for the rules. It's makes no sense, and that's why I love it. Like,
and the animation in it is all him like
limboing
and doing crazy like speed filing out of a giant pile.
It's so much fun, and everything is like with the beat, him throwing out all the files and like stacking them. It's
wicked.
It's really good.
Phil, sir, where do you want to travel now into interdimensional bus of music? Have a good look. A good look at that list.
Oh, let's do the one from the Beck episode.
Yay! Because we have a broken friend.
It's going to be good. It's got Beck.
More outdated pants. I like them tight.
My broken friend could do it. Beck!
Yeah.
I think he improvised it would not surprise me.
Yeah, he improvised all of that.
I think Beck
yeah.
would have approached the Tommy Lee Jones thing of coming in and be like, well, this whole thing's stupid, so I'm going to say whatever I want. Well, not that this whole thing is stupid, but basically I'm just going to do whatever I want.
I think he pretty
That's
much,
cool.
he went up to them and said, please make fun of me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Please make, More, yeah. do whatever you want to
also,
me.
It's,
I mean, his interjections in the song really make it. They help so much.
I was going to say, it's a great gag to have someone launching into a song and dance and what? Just someone being like, no, stop.
It.
It's like the whole Monty Python thing.
What's the deal?
Stop that. No music when I'm around.
I love the stuff before that even kicks off with his, that would be good for soup. It's just really.
I like him tight.
Or just like the,
Give it up.
Give it up.
And he's a guest artist that we actually didn't have to look up.
Yes, we know who Beck is.
Yeah.
Last
name.
Fucking Donovan. I still don't know who Donovan is.
Oh, God, do we have to do that song?
No, we do not have to do Donovan.
Okay, sweet.
Atlantis. I mean, is it a song, really? It's just him talking over a...
Oh, yeah, he's just...
I would say it's spoken music, spoken poetry.
I'm
going
to say spoken poetry,
like,
so we don't have to include it.
What's
slam poetry?
It's not
Beat
slam
poetry.
What do you call it? It's like spoken... It's just
spoken
called spoken
word,
isn't it?
Yeah.
And it could be over music, but it's not quite specific to a genre.
Yeah.
Right? Because slam poems are very specific. Whereas, spoken word is just kind of whatever you want.
It's like Rocket Man.
With the William Shatner Rocket
William
Man.
William Shatner,
real Rocket Man.
I mean,
he
has whole albums of spoken word stuff.
It's great. Wow. I love it.
It's awesome.
I think it's like a subset.
I can't get behind that. Check it out. It's really good.
To the window, to the wall, to the sweat drips down my balls.
On that note, what's next?
Oh, let's go to I May As Well Fucking Jump.
What?
I may as well jump. Those sleazy naked scammers.
I completely forgot about that one.
Yeah, it's a really, really kind of show tuney one, isn't it? Yeah.
It's the first song that they did when they brought the movies back. So it's been on hiatus for about 4 or 5 years, and that's the very first thing they kind of pop up.
Yeah.
It's a very good melody to kind of get the hook in, and also banjo.
It's
got a western pluck strings.
Do,
I mean, John DiMaggio's in a band that is kind of very country inspired. I forget
John
what
DiMaggio,
it's called.
Come on this podcast,
please. What I love is he's kind of this amazing troll that kind of punishes me for tagging him and stuff, where he won't like the status, but if someone else makes a comment about it, he'll like that.
What? Is he doing this on purpose?
I think so.
Can we just come on to have us be like, oh, we really like you.
John, can we like do a song with you?
I mean, back to this song as well. I really like how when Katie Siegel sings, it's like in a low register. I don't know. I know that's like her vocal range, yeah. But it's just quite nice that she's not trying to do like a whole...
Lars popped the question.
Exactly. She's got a real healthy baritone.
Yeah. I do like that it's also like, because it's sort of half spoken. Yeah. It's almost a bit sprechung. That, like, it doesn't require them to be amazing singers for it to work.
Have you seen the Scrubs musical episode?
Yeah, I have.
Where Elliot, like, that's the same thing that she does.
What's her song?
Because
I remember there's some really great songs in there. My favorite one's probably Everything Comes Down to Poop.
Yeah. From the top of the head to the tip of your shoe. We can find out what's wrong with you by taking a look at your number twos.
Was it?
It's Guy Love.
Between all it is. Two guys. And there's also one with Carla where it's like, am I something or Dominican?
Am I Puerto Rican or Dominican?
Yeah.
See, I'm just lost because I haven't seen this. I have seen the Buffy musical episode.
I have not.
That's really good.
That's Once More with Feeling?
Yes.
Yeah.
That is good.
Oh, and Willow and Tara.
I've seen the Muppets episode of Angel. If
that is a very good episode, also. Yes,
that's one of my tangentially favorites. Related.
I love that's what happens when you let a showrunner have enough time that they'll just throw in one batshit crazy fucking episode.
Yeah. Well, we might do a musical episode of Shut Up at some point.
Ooh,
we kind of do that anyway. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Isn't that what we're doing right now?
Yes. But I do, whatever that song was, it's fine.
It's fine. Like
it. Yeah, it's not the most spectacular one, but it serves a plot. And it's
but it's also
nice,
a good one to get all your characters in. Yeah. Like, you know, they've each got their kind of reaction, and then they've got the group kind of versus Leela, and then group versus Fry, and then also Father Christmas, like, about to gun them all down. It's nice. I like it.
Hey, Ellen. Where do you want to go on the wheel of music?
Let's go. Maybe let's throw a stinker in there. Let's go the Kwanzaa rap. Is that the bad one or was it the Robonica one?
The Kwanzaa one.
I think the...
No.
I think the Robonica one is the one I can't hear. Let's do that one.
The Robonica one. Yeah. You know what I reckon it is? I reckon the one that we can't hear is... I think it's another one in...
Is it not on this list?
No, I don't think it is. It should be. But it's not. Well, look, just Sean.
Well,
Ben.
We've already said.
Oh, it's Toy Shop's Going to War. There you go, Ben is big score.
Well, let's do that one then.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Come here, YouTube.
Because I wonder if I'll be able to hear the lyrics now.
There you go. This Trinity's going to war.
On Ben is big score.
Got my TIE fighter out of the hangar. Jump back, Jack, because I'm Jewish and I'm on dead.
I don't know what's so missing about that. It just doesn't grab
me. It's not mastered like great.
Yeah.
I have to really focus.
Yeah,
I take back a lot of what I said. Like, it's not a stinker. Like, I really like the hooks in it and how they kind of switch from different styles for, you know, the different, like, we've got Kwanzaa Bot, we've got Hanukkah Zombie.
Mark Hamill.
Yeah, Mark Hamill with the TIE Fighter reference. But I just can't hear. Oh, and
you just
I love
can't
how,
hear it very well.
I love how they sample the toy box, the ballerina.
Mm. Yeah.
Into the Kwanzaa rap. That's really cool.
I just tune out a bit. Like, yeah. But the thing is, I really dig the song.
If I could hear the lyrics, I think I'd be like, duh, like, you know.
Yeah, it's a good hook. You just can't hear what they're singing.
Yeah.
What?
I get it about every second line. Huh?
What?
What? That was all very Mark Wahlberg acting from The Happening.
What? I still haven't seen The Happening, by the way. Should I?
No.
Is it worth it? One good thing. I'm coming for you with The Happening. One
Have
good
they done
thing.
It?
I don't know.
I don't know.
One good thing, if you're going to, don't. Because I'm doing it with you.
No.
It's happening.
Yeah, I think that would be a really excellent number because they've really
You laugh
nailed...
into the mic, damn you, when I make a good joke.
Brilliant. Uh-huh. Very natural. But they've really nailed the different genres of music. It's just...
Yeah, you just you don't get the writing.
Yeah, and
so you
I
tune
don't...
out.
Yeah.
Phil, sir. But you...
Oh, let's do Robot Hell.
Good, because you can't take this. We're doing this last. Oh, the audience doesn't know.
That's
Scotty doesn't know.
It's gonna be good. And this, by the way, is Chris's favorite. I'm pretty sure. I'm speaking for sexy Chris because he loves. It's his favorite episode. Look, I'm just gonna keep talking until I find it. Here you go.
Oh yeah.
That's so bad for the disc.
They're in hell. Fuck yeah.
That's so good.
I also didn't
realize
that Dan Castellaneta had that sort of range. Like that last note at the end.
Yeah.
Fucking...
You know what this kind of reminds me of? I mean, this is like a Dan Castellaneta kind of jumping off point, but it does really remind me of a kind of lesser friend like me. In terms of like the setup and how they move through the space. Even having like that big like in the higher range ending note.
Have you tried going back and watching Return of Jafar?
No.
Because that's Dan Castellaneta as a genie.
Yeah, that was my jumping off point.
Yeah, and it's like first animation aside, because it's atrocious. It's the first director DVD Disney thing.
They gave him like the budget for like a sandwich.
Yeah. And they ate the sandwich.
And they ate the sandwich. Then they still had to animate the film.
But I know, I can remember zero songs from that.
Yeah.
I remember songs from Prince of Thieves.
Oh,
King of Thieves.
Actually, no, I do remember. It's terrible. It's Gilbert Gottfried. Song they gave Gilbert
what?
Gottfried.
What song could I sing?
Yeah,
that's a great
love
song. Welcome to Robot Hell. Welcome to Shut Up and Take My Podcast.
We haven't done that. My favorite thing of his is this reading. Little skit he did where he reads 50 Shades of Grey.
Gilbert,
yeah. Entering my
vagina, clitoris.
The goddess in me is dancing.
it's got these like lovely attractive young ladies like listening to it on their run, and they're just like, oh.
Gilbert, we can fandangle this. If you enjoy Futurama or if you've ever watched Futurama,
not listen to our show.
Come on to the podcast and we'll
I don't listen to your show.
Also, do we want him?
Yes. Hell yes.
I thought he was a shitty person.
Nah.
Well, he's definitely not going to listen now.
Oh no!
He's a good. He's a.
Well,
he's
you
a Gilbert.
Make jokes after a tsunami.
He's
I'm
a Gilbert
sorry.
Goodfried. You're about
Goodfried.
To say.
Yeah, I was going to say that.
Well, Gilbert got. I don't know.
Got fired.
Gilbert got fired from Shut Up.
Anyway, this song is very good.
Oh yeah,
The writing is fantastic. The tune is catchy. Mm. It breakneck speed, but you get everything.
Yeah.
Tons of cool puns. You learn about all of very creatively all about Bender's various crimes.
And this is
we
probably
have the Beastie Boys.
Beastie Boys show up.
This is probably the only song that has a callback as well. They bring this song back the next time we. Like in one of the movies, which is Beast with a Billion Backs, I think. Like they cut to hell, and he's like, "Oh, you made a wrong note 200 years back. Well, we have to start again."
Yeah,
like they bring that hook back, which is great.
Yeah, and also like, I love big bands. I love jazz, and so having kind of like horns and a jazz orchestration in this is just so much fun.
Mm.
Yeah, it's really like a big kind of like character number. Like this is where Dan Castellaneta.
That's what establishes the Robot Devil is a really favorite character for a lot of people, I think.
Yeah,
yes.
That specific song that nails it. It's in the context of the episode as well. It's just really ace. Like it doesn't feel kind of shoehorned in. I feel like the one, the little banjo one we listened to before, feels like a little.
This is a song we are going to do now.
Yeah.
Whereas this feels like it should belong in a musical.
Yeah,
like 100%. This is where you establish. The character, not only the character, but move the plot through.
Yes.
And then you get to also flex the muscles of your
It's cast. A good use of your Dan Castellaneta.
And the good. Devil playing instruments and having musical talent or gifting musical talent. It's like a long-running trope. So,
yeah.
It fits really well.
Yeah, well, it comes into play with Devil's Hands.
New song.
Santa's just a crummy, empty-handed jerk.
Oh! Jesus.
Shut your yap.
This is one of my favorite songs.
Yeah.
I love this song so much. I used to hate it as a kid. Mm-hmm. I don't know why. I was an idiot. But
it is the kind of thing of like, it's a thing that it's an earworm.
Yeah.
Like it gets in, and then all of this song is the same tune over and over and over again. Mm. That's why it's easy to kind of remember because they just keep repeating it until
the rhyme scheme's the same.
Yeah.
But some of those lyrics are horrible. It's great.
It's like
shut your yaps and get to work.
It's the juxtaposition, right?
Yeah.
It's a happy Christmas jingle about exploiting tiny innocent
elves.
Workers.
Yeah. And also the acting they use for the elves is really good. Like just like there's a toy lodged in my brain. Like
and
it's
Fry's look of horror.
Yeah, like it's really that kind of like no one really paying attention to the real true horror that's happening.
Yeah, also, well, except for Bender, who just doubles down on the true horror.
But I love the specificity of not just kicking them, like booting them in
the stomach.
That's horrifying.
Well, I guess to wind them, but not hurt them enough that they can't work.
Doesn't. No, I'm not going there. Yeah. All right. So,
I just love that everything's average and a bit shit as
it's adequate.
Yeah. And they live terrible lives and they're totally exploited. It's hilarious.
It's the better of, it's the better of the elves' songs. And it's mastered well. Yeah. It's mastered well. Ellen.
What?
Where would you like to go?
Speaking of exploited workers, let's go to the Grunkalunkers.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
I just saw one of my favorite quotes from Futurama. What? My leg feels funny! whalers on the moon. Poplars. What did you ask for again?
Grunkalunker.
Grunkers. Where are you fucking Grunkers? That sounded like a racist term.
It's the slurm one.
Yeah, where does it say that? Whalers, Santa, Robonica, Poplars, Justice, Friend, Orphan, Kwanzaa. There you go. Maybe.
Yeah, that's the one.
When will that be? Soon enough. That's not soon enough. Hey, what's behind that door?
No, that wasn't it. No. Because there's...
That's the reprise.
Yeah. There's a better song. It's great. Because obviously we can
like,
just cut out.
Well, it's very much a ripoff of the Impolimus songs.
Asking questions in school is a great way to learn.
If you try that stuff here, you might get your legs broke.
So lovely.
Like, I feel like the purpose of that one is that it's a bit crap. Like, it doesn't fit the tune very well.
No.
Yeah. It doesn't really rhyme properly either.
No. There's a great moment where you think it's not going to rhyme at all. Where it's like
broke.
Yeah, it's a great place to learn, but you try that stuff here and you'll get your legs broke instead of you'll get burned or whatever.
Yeah,
and
you're like, what?
The shit is accentuated by the fact that we watched it on YouTube of a not quite steady camera looking at a
someone
TV.
Someone coughing into the background.
Yeah. Blah, blah. Don't know why that one's not on YouTube.
And I don't know what that TV is. It's a Vizio.
It's a very old CRT TV, it looks like.
Yeah.
This is also, the difference in this one a little bit is that it's parodying an actual musical very closely.
Yeah.
Yes.
Tune and setup and episode and everything.
Yeah,
right?
And the kind of like vocal nature of the Oompa Loompas. Like, you've got really gruff ones, and then you've got the ones that kind of like, like it's quite nasal and high and reedy, and you've got that kind of like... Yeah, those are the kind of range of the Grunkalunkers to kind of match suit. And it's all a bit weird and shit.
Yeah, but it feels
just
intentional.
Like, like it's meant to be. Like like the Oompa Loompas are.
Yeah, they are weird.
A bit weird and shit. Like,
I don't feel like the other songs...
Exploited as fuck.
I feel not many other songs parody something
other
established
songs
so closely.
Mm. No.
You might be wrong, but...
I took out a few... Like, by the way, for those that are screaming about other musical stings, I've taken out things that are mostly, like, established songs, like when they do Don't Worry, Be Happy in the sting.
Right,
like, I don't count that because it's just a
song. It's not their own original writing.
I've tried to keep, like, original songs mostly that are here. Mm.
What original song are we going to next?
Oh, what? Is it your turn or is it my
turn?
I think it's your turn.
We have the mouse.
Oh, yes. There you go. Take it.
Very quickly.
Fishy Joe's, what they're made of is a mystery where they come from. No one knows. You can pick them, you can lick them, you can chew them, you can stick them.
That's the Sailor's Hornpipe, which is
We had a housemate that used to live here, one of the 30,000 people that have been through this
have
house.
Come and gone.
That so just should tell you something about what you like to live with, guys. Just
Well, just me, because I'm the common denominator.
Yeah.
So there's just something wrong with me.
I think
but
so.
They knew
it's taken you so long to work it out.
They knew this song off by heart. They would just sing it around the house. It's great. It's great.
Pop it in your mouth when you can.
I love this, but I have one gripe.
What is your gripe?
I wish... I know that they've got... You can lick them, you can... blah, blah, blah. What is it? You can lick them, you can...
I don't know.
Stick them, you can...
Okay. I wasn't sure if stick was already used, because if it's not used...
You can lick them, you can chew them, you can stick them if you...
Okay.
You can
chew them,
never
you can
mind.
Stick them.
Yeah,
because I would have... Otherwise, I would have liked it to be you can stick one up your nose to keep the alliteration of ick. The internal rhyme of ick, but that's fine. I'm okay with it.
You're cool with it?
Yeah. They already use stick it, so that's
fine. It's a good jingle. You remember it and makes you want to eat a poplar.
I don't want to eat a poplar.
Well, you already have. You're eating three.
Oh, no.
I'm kind of losing interest here. I best be rolling out. But before I go, the most...
I, There's two things I remember from this. Number one is that it's the most I've ever learned about Kwanzaa.
Yes, yeah. Totally. Me too.
Did you guys ever watch The Proud Family?
No.
No.
Oh, because they had a really good episode on Kwanzaa. Like, The Proud Family, it's this...
Proud Family.
It's a very proud family. It was a cartoon show. I want to say... What was Recess on? Was that on Cartoon Network?
Wasn't Nickelodeon one? No, it's Cartoon Network.
Cartoon Network. Yeah. It was one of those Cartoon Network shows of the same kind of era. And it was like Penny Proud and her family.
Yeah, yeah.
Like this black family and kind of like... They had a really good episode on Kwanzaa that was really educational, but I don't remember anything because I'm trash.
Thank you for that song.
What's your drama?
It was economic...
cooperation.
Yeah, that's the one.
Cooperative economics.
And another one was a dance.
One of them's
freely.
Creativity.
Yeah, I'm losing
dancing.
Interest. Yeah. Best be rolling out.
But the most,
I love the fact he just gets bored halfway through. That is the best part of the song.
I also remember that Ellen made the exact same noise when we watched the episode when Barbados talks about his sexual proclivities. And she went,
Oh, like the one I just made.
Yeah, it was
damn
the exact
it.
Same noise.
It's like in How I Met Your Mother where they're like, did you see I had a naked lady? It's like... what do you mean? You make a naked lady noise when you see a naked lady. He's like, oh. He's like, I don't do that. And she's like, oh yeah. And then she like flashes him and walks away. And then he goes.
I just love that they just use Coolio the way you're meant to use Coy. It's like, yeah, just give him a rap song.
Give him a rap song.
I also
make him burst through the wall.
I really like the groove of this. You know what it sounds a lot to me like? Not quite, but like it's reminiscent of Groove Is in the Heart.
A little bit.
Like the bass
yeah.
line.
Yeah.
It's really cool. It's a nice groove. I wish I did learn. I wish it was a bit clearer so I could actually learn a bit more about Kwanzaa.
Fuck
well,
off, Rumbly,
whenever they involve Coolio, they can't master it properly. Like, again, you have to concentrate to listen to the
it
words.
It is very. Yeah. It's Coolio just like whisper, like a whisper rapper. Know. They're like, we forgot to put the gain
he
up.
Comes
shit.
In the, he comes yeah. in the night and he whispers these raps.
Oh, fuck. I took out the wrong one. Oh, well. Look, let's just keep going until we find something. You know what? Let's just go to Ooh, I just got goosebumps.
Mm. We haven't even got the visuals yet.
Sean's got goosebumps. Aww. That's so sweet.
He's a deeply feeling man.
Oh, we're ending on this one, by the way.
Almost brung a
is there?
Tear
are you
drawing,
sure there aren't any other
oh, look,
special
I'm
ones?
No. That used every single character.
Uses all the main cast, isn't it?
Yeah. That
is irony.
Brannigan saying encore.
Yeah, brilliant. You've got
Nixon.
Nixon. Yeah.
Ken Keeler. I'm pretty sure wrote this. Mm. And that sucks with Ken Keeler, as I think. I think Josh Weinstein told us, he's like, I'm sorry, you're not going to get Ken.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm like, no. Ken, come on.
No. We want the full set.
can you think of any other animation that finishes their season, well, at the time, with an opera?
No, I can't think of that.
Look, they're definitely...
I dare you.
They're definitely top of the list. That list is one.
Yeah.
But do we talk about like the separate kind of parts? I mean, because we all like kind of... shifted and were very feely in the ending holophone, Fry's little holophone, Leela's voice acting in just telling Fry to keep going is beautiful enough.
Gorgeous.
But then also the melody is so simple. It's got a very kind of Danny Elfman, like lots of oohs and ahs feel. And the fact that it's kind of like a bit...
it's the simpler kind of... rendition of the feeling he's getting across in the main opera, right? Which is grander, but it's the same. It's like the same thing, but kind of simplified.
Mm.
It's more true to Fry's character in a lot of ways. The robot hands give him this kind of artificial grandeur that it's not quite.
It's not him.
Yeah,
and also like it's way more feeling when you take away some of the like words.
You strip
just
it right back.
Have the oohs and the.
Well,
it's
we
so
listened to that whole thing without the visuals, as you said. Like it's just you just got to listen to it.
Mm.
Yeah,
it's great.
It's gorgeous.
And the writing's awesome,
and everyone's doing so well. Like, one of my favorite lines is like. Fry coming back and Billy West like a deal is a deal even with a dirty deal, like he's really like attacking it really like giving it the kind of like weight
the
and
accusatory
momentum
nature of it.
Like that an opera actually needs, like they're actually all acting through.
Well, they thought it was the end.
Yeah,
yeah. That's true.
Maybe there's another opera in the final episode.
Yeah. Ooh.
I don't think there is.
And Katie Sagal, like her singing, she's got some really great hard jumps. Like there's one, I can't remember what line it is, but it goes.
Get-ish.
Yeah, that is one of my favorite lines, but like it quickly descends a few like kind of notes.
A few octaves.
Like it's quite a jump from kind of like, it's not quite a donkey where you go like that kind of thing. It's the reverse, but it's kind of like a really quick melody jump that is not jarring at all. Like she just handles it really smoothly. And it's just really cool to see.
Ease.
And also the lyrics are kind of funny and how melodramatic and...
Yes.
So I think
we haven't
talked about him, but like, yeah, Christopher Ting, he's the composer for Futurama. He was there throughout the entire thing. So a lot of credit has to go to the Ting man.
For sure. Oh, yeah. I think it's worth mentoring.
Mentor someone.
In the way. A little baby.
It's worth mentioning that our response to the updated theme tune in the movies.
Oh, we love that.
We were like, what is this?
They were bringing that back for the...
I think it plays out the episode sometimes.
What was different about it? I cannot remember.
It was just grander.
And it had this like really nice little like accent notes in it that were really
I do feel like it did have a bigger drive and some of the little accompaniments were a lot stronger. Like you could actually hear a lot of what... kind of makes up that melody. You're looking it up.
He's looking it up.
I'm trying.
This is a song called My
Go away, Bender.
Yes!
Batman, yeah.
It's got heaps more in it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A lot more of the kind of theremin, kind of like, ooh,
the bit that already like sticks in your mind is lifted out even more.
Yeah, and it comes down then so much harder, like, bam, 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 like it really lands it, which is just so satisfying.
We watched it. I remember we were just immediately perked up.
Ooh, we like this.
Yeah.
And also, oh, this is something I have never seen before. It's exciting. It's great.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh,
and we never saw Xylax again.
No, we didn't. I was about to ask, did we ever see Xylax? No.
The last episode.
Guys, that was music.
That was some of the songs, most of the songs of Futurama. Fantastic.
We're whalers on a moon. We carry a harpoon.
We sing a song.
Merry tune.
There were no whales, so we tell tall tales.
Sing a whaling tune.
Oh, wow.
It's literally been about 2.5 years
since. What's the
Coolio
quote?
I wasn't even on the show for that.
What's the Coolio quote? I'm losing interest. I better go.
No.
I better roll out. I should use that
like,
more.
I think it's like, I think there was another one. I think there was some others.
Have we talked about the Donald Glover hat store rap? I did it before we started, but like, it just, that Coolio line reminds me a lot of when Donald Glover... in his stand-up show, talks about how people bemoan the fact that, like, old rap was better and new rap is weird. And he's like, did you guys hear old rap? It was like, I went to the hat store today and I bought myself a hat.
So Will Smith, basically.
Yes. There's a reason he's not doing any music lately.
Guys.
What?
And girls. And
yes.
And listeners of all credos.
Yeah,
and,
you. I'm looking at you.
Yeah, that you,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, put down the book.
You,
all right.
On.
Pay attention to the road. You driving to work right now?
We're going to be back next week, but it's still not going to be an episode.
No way, Sean! Come on! They want the Futurama content.
Do you?
Well, this is Futurama content.
I guess, yeah. We're slowly zeroing back on the Futurama.
I promise you it's worth it. And, like, you know, the longer we wait, the more episodes
we're
you get.
Edging.
What are we doing next week?
I don't know.
What do you mean? Why aren't we doing the show?
Because... Oh, okay.
This is like Sean's way of telling us the podcast is over.
Yeah, that's
he's
right.
Just gradually phasing
us out.
Because we got the DVDs. We can't use that old excuse.
Hey, Sean, put the... Actually, we don't have a DVD yet for season 7. No, we do. No, we didn't.
We because do because we watched like four of the episodes.
No, we've watched one from season 7.
Have we only watched one?
Yes.
Do we watch it on DVD?
No, I asked you guys to watch it in other legal ways.
Definitely. I watched it in a very legal way.
Yes. It's been a long time.
Is that why we're still not doing that?
No. So, Sean, put the beep here.
Yeah. Okay.
But what are we doing next week?
Who knows?
We'll find out.
Fucking hell.
It's a surprise.
Professional podcasters.
It's a surprise for everyone, including us.
Yeah.
But we will be professional if you send us money. So please send us some money. Thank you.
We're actually, by the way, seriously considering setting up a Patreon.
Are we getting to that point? I will sell my Gamer Girl bathwater.
Sick!
So
someone can get seriously ill.
I will sell the grease that builds up on my gamer mouse.
Yeah, you're going to sell your... Essentially, your gamer girl bathwater. Yeah.
And I'll come over to your house and do the dishes.
Sick. Awesome.
To whoever our listener is.
Yes.
America.
That's the $10 reward.
He's coming. All right. It's taking him a while.
Yeah. By the time you get there, there's a ginormous, like, 3 months of dishes for you to do.
For, like, a $10
donation.
We are actually considering a Patreon. So, honestly, voice it to us if that is something you're interested in. We have a bucket load of unreleased content, including and the ideas of doing Let's Plays, of doing other role-playing content, of the other mystery podcasts that have not been released. And there's a multitude of things that we could offer.
I don't know, I mean, to be poor me, but we've been doing this for, like, what, 2-3 years? And it's work, you know? We have to edit, we have to, you know, get ourselves together and record.
We're looking at, you know, making some serious decisions in terms of making a Baby Beard Media kind of home for us. It's a lot that kind of comes into play. And so we obviously love doing it for you guys, and hopefully you guys love us doing it for you enough to kind of
As Sean says, this is something you think you might get on board with, then let us know.
Yeah.
I've found out now, we don't need to say the stuff at the end because I've made that little tag at the end of the...
Oh, God bless. This is the kind of things that we can speed up with your Patreon money.
We'll think about it like sooner than 2 years into the podcast. Having an outro thing.
Oh, wow.
Right.
But I like us kind of...
Cobbling it together.
Scrambling, everybody. Even though we know it's coming and yet never having the foresight to kind of get our...
Hey, Ellen, think fast.
Oh no.
I've been Phil.
I've been Sean.
I've been Ellen.
Bye.
Bye.
Good. Oh. Bye.
Thanks for tuning in. If you'd like to contact us, you can do so by emailing us at babybeardmedia@gmail.com. Our socials are Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram @BabyBeardMedia. And if you're looking for a way to support us, the best way you can do it is by jumping onto iTunes or the podcast app and giving us a 5-star rating and a nice review. It goes a long way to helping us. Otherwise, if you'd like to join us next week.
Anyway.
Guy, I was like on a date with last night. We ended up watching like a fucking whole musical theory YouTube video essay. I was like, is this a good date or a bad date? I don't know.
And what did you decide it was?
I don't know, but let me tell you what. There was a lot of fingering happening. Musical pun.
Oh, but also sex.
What? On this podcast?
Yeah.
I went to the hat store today and I bought myself a hat. Ha ha. Played a game last night. It was called like
Why?
Madness.
Why, Sean?
Goodman's gonna get off his ass at one point and make our theme. That guy does
Goodman,
nothing.
Get off your fucking ass.
Fucking useless.
He's the laziest cunt I've
Why
ever
is
met.
That?
Let's give it 10 seconds silence. Nah, 9 seconds.
Ever-changing nature of my sexual proclivities.
I think there's one called
Encore.
You surrender
my hands.
Oh, yes.
Then he probably won't
want me dating her.
Hey, guys, do you have any things you want to say before I press this big red button here? It's not even red. I lied.
Oh,
it's white.
Project Red.
Check
out Roll to Cast.
Please check it out.
Yeah.
No, I don't know.
Bye.
Bye.